Get started. Can you hear the music?
I can.
Okay, great. All right, so I always suggest to sit in a chair that plants your feet nice and firmly on the ground where your knees are parallel to your hips. So it's not too low, it's not too high, right? So if you have any of those issues, you can always put a pillow or something underneath your feet, right? Or a block, if you have a block. Make sure your back of your chair, you can actually put a blanket behind there just to give it a nice support so you have a nice tall spine, right? Just readjust your seat. Maybe you'd like to just kind of sway the hips a little bit just to see what feels good, right? This is seated chair yoga. I'm Haejin, and it's about 45 minutes. I always kind of go a little bit over, but you know, at that last relaxation is pretty important, so you kind of get carried away moving a little bit. But lots of stretches. We'll start out with our head first. Before we do that, of course, let's close our eyes, place our hands down on our thighs, palms down. Just adjust your head and make sure it's right on top of your shoulders and gently close those eyes. Noticing any discomfort you might have in your body, releasing it. Finding comfort. Eyes remaining closed, feeling the sensation of your body. Drifting the awareness toward your mind. Just allowing yourself to notice what might be moving in your mind. Just clearing your mind with the intention to breathe and stretch your body, nourish and balance with the physical, bringing your awareness to your breath, allowing that inhale and exhale to be created by you, nourishing body with your own conscious breath. Spine long, lengthen the edge of your inhale. Slowly exhaling down from your seat. The belly drawing into the spine. Water flowing. Continue your breath. Eventually, become aware of a beautiful four-petal white lotus flower at the base of your spine. This beautiful white lotus flower resting at the base of your spine. And as you start to continue to breathe your breath. Allow your breath to start to open and close the petals of the lotus flower. As you inhale, gently feel and mentally aware of the opening of the petals. As you exhale, noticing the petals slowly close back. Inhale, open. Exhale, closing. Using your breath gently, opening and closing. The white lotus flower. And place your spine. Gently and slowly release the center of the flower, continuing to breathe down even smoother. Taking a moment here now to amplify gratitude. This moment. You make an intention for your practice this afternoon. An intention to move, to consciously become aware of all the subtle movements, physical. And gently and slowly flutter your eyes open. Coming back to your space. Let's start to begin some movement of our body. Let's begin with our head. Take a deep breath in, always lengthening the spine upwards as you keep that breath in. And as you exhale, start to slowly rotate the head to the right. Feeling that little bit of a stretch. As you exhale, here for a couple more breaths, inhale and exhale. Giving that stretch, the exhale, maybe allowing you to rotate a little bit further without any difficulty. And as you take your next inhale, gently start to move the head back, rotate it back. Take a deep breath in here, again, as you exhale, contract that belly in, start to rotate off. And just breathe here for a few breaths. Just allowing your breath to be the guide to release any tension in that neck muscle, left side of your neck. And using your inhale to slowly bring you back. Back. As you take your next inhale, start to gaze up, stretching the front of your neck very slightly without too much compression of the vertebrae in the back of your neck. Exhale, start to slowly reach the chin down, your gaze coming back down to your feet, your chair, getting the stretch of the back of the room. You can do that a couple of times if you want. Inhale all the way up. Really gentle movement, no straining of your neck. Gazing up, exhale, gazing gently down. Rotating it up and down. One last breath, inhaling up, stretching it all up and exhaling, stretching it all the way down. Stretching all the sides of your neck. Inhaling all the way back to center now. Not gazing up, sitting straight ahead. Really nice. Using your left hand, we're going to provide, place that, the hand, the palm of your hand, right on the right temple, right? We're not going to use our arms to pull our head to the side, right? We're just going to use it as like a weight to kind of bring in a little bit more pressure. So I take a deep breath in here, lengthen the spine. As you exhale, start to move the head all the way to the left, right? And then feeling the weight of the hand kind of give you a little bit more of a stretch in the right side. Breathing here, feeling that stretch. Allowing your breath to help heal and release any tension you might have on that body. And using the inhale, releasing the hand, coming all the way back to center, release that arm back down through your thighs. And let's do the other side. Your right hand to the left temple. Place it gently on there, and as you take a deep breath in, lengthen the spine. As you exhale, start to move it all the way to the right. Feeling that stretch, feeling kind of the back side of that neck. Feel that. Feel like something is bothering you, maybe you need to reach that shoulder down a little bit deeper, stretch a little bit deeper. Gravity, the weight of that hand kind of pulling the head a little bit more to the left. Breathe in and out. That nice stretch from the neck. Breath to help release any tension. And as you take your next thing down, release the hands and slowly fall your back up the center. Really nice. And then start to inhale, start to move the shoulders up. Really nice movement up. As you exhale, start to move the shoulders back and down. Inhale all the way up, and exhale all the way down. Just releasing the muscle, the tension of that muscle. Inhale all the way back up, and exhale, reaching all the way back down. And just a little bit of movement to release if that felt like tensing a little bit. And then we're gonna do it the other way. Inhale, reach it all the way up towards the ear. Exhale, forward and now, inhale all the way back up, exhale forward and down. One last time, inhale forward and up, and exhale all the way down. Oh, just moving your body just to release any tension that you created, tighten it up a little bit, right? Anyway, this is all about just releasing all the tension, especially in the upper body, but we will do a little bit of core too, a little bit of leg exercises. So from here, we're just going to inhale all the way up. We're gonna have our hands go straight up to the sky. Then as you exhale, you're gonna turn the palms away from each other to the outside, and then you'll start to reach it back behind you. Start coming a little bit forward, right? And then exhale, come all the way forward with the arms, cross it, whichever one on top, and then start to hug yourself by grabbing the shoulders. Breathe in here, feel the stretch of the shoulder blade. Just think of breath kind of opening you up. Inhale, expanding you a little bit. All that space, and as you exhale, releasing it, hugging yourself a little bit. And one last time, inhale, hug and expand, Then exhale, release. Oh. This time, inhale, release the arms all the way back to your side. And then exhale again, all the way back. Notice how your shoulders, maybe the shoulder blades, maybe it starts to fold down. Place your hands, grab the chair now. Your feet firmly planted. Maybe you want to come a little bit more to the edge of your seat as you hold on to that chair. Your spine is nice and long, right? And starting from here, we're going to basically move our legs just a bit. This is our little bit of a core workout. So make sure the shoulders are nice and relaxed. There's no tension. And sometimes when we're tensing, our shoulders start to come up. Try to just release it. Grab the chair. And we're just going to move the leg. As you take a deep breath in, we'll start to raise the right knee. And holding here just for a couple of breaths, feeling the muscles contracting, holding it in place. Maybe flexing your feet. Engage the core, make sure the belly is drawing into the spine. One last breath. As you exhale, you gently reach it all the way down. Ah, worked out that thigh muscle. You can totally feel it on top, I'm sure. I felt that. Let's do the other side. Inhale, raise that left leg up as high as you'd like. Keep the spine nice and long, not rounding your back. Flex your feet and just breathe in and out. Okay, we're kind of tensing a little bit of that thigh muscle. We're engaging the core so we stay nice and tall. Just breathing in and out. One more breath. As you exhale, now place your hands on either side of your thighs, right? So what you're trying to do is here to create like a tripod with your hands on your thighs. So when we start to arch around, we've got some kind of support to help us so we don't dump anything into our lower back. So as you take a deep breath in, you're going to reach the chest. So you're arching, reach the chest forward. So you're arching the back forward. As you exhale, start from the lower belly, start to round everything back, and the head starts to tuck in to the chest. Inhale again, reach the chest forward, feel the arching of the back, shoulders pulling back, exhale, rounding, releasing the breath of the belly, and again, just a few more times on your own, inhaling and arching that back. Exhale, your belly draws into the spine as everything else moves back. Just a couple more. And make that stretch of your spine, really creating space as you breathe. Just allowing your breath to roll up your trunk, creating the movement, the vertebrae. Just nourishing your body with these slight, subtle movements, right? And when you're finished, come on, release to that neutral spine. Like the move your shoulders. Deep breath in. From here, we're just going to do a bit of a twist. We're going to reach the left leg up and over the right left thigh, the right thigh over. And if you have a pillow, if you want your feet to dangle, you can. If you have a pillow or something to rest your heel on, you can. I have a block, right? If not, it's okay. If it feels okay, that's okay, right? Make sure you're nice and tall. Take a deep breath in. Hold your hands to that knee. And exhale, just a couple breaths here. Just feeling that right hip, right? You're feeling a little stretch there. Then slowly, using your left hand, you're going to just place it on the outside of that thigh. You're going to use the right hand and grab that seat. Deep breath in here. As you exhale, start from the lower belly, contract it in, twist from the lower belly, and then the ribs twisting. As you exhale, the chest twisting to the back, shoulders twisting back, and then the head raising all the way back. And just breathing here, a couple of breaths. Now lengthening the spine, exhale, twisting the little bit more. When you're ready, using the inhale, start to slowly twist back from the head, the shoulders, the chest, the ribs, and the belly. Let's come and reach that leg back. Make sure you're planting it nice and comfy with the other side. Inhale, reach that left leg up and over, crossing it the thighs. And again, if you have a block or a blanket or a pillow, you can always rest your feet there. Just like that. And just stay here for a moment, feeling the stretch in that left hip. It's allowing the breath to help kind of release the tension right now. Taking maybe one last breath before we come into this nice twist we're going to create. Using the right hand to the outside, using the left hand, grabbing that chair for support to keep the spine nice and tall. Inhale here. As you exhale, contract the belly, start to twist through the lower belly, chest, shoulders, the head. So, feeling that stretch, but keeping the chest nice and long and tall, not wrapped. One last breath, maybe stay here a little bit more, it's so good for the throat. One last breath, using the inhale to bring you back to the center. Slowly twisting, very gently, all the way back. Maybe the shoulders need to release again, maybe there's something you'd like to just release down. Shoulders away from the reach down to your tailbone. And then inhale, place the foot back down firmly on the mat. And from here, we're going to slowly do like a half sun salutation as we're in the seated pose, like a seated mountain pose. Probably what this is called, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to place our hands together. Inhale, circle the hands all the way up. Lengthen the spine all the way up. Maybe watching the hands touch and then gently exhaling all the way, midway, all the way down to your heart center. Breathing through the nose. Inhale, circle all the way up. Lengthen the spine. As you exhale, gently go prayer hands to your heart center. One last time. Inhale, circle all the way up. And exhale all the way down to your heart center. This time we're going to fold. We're going to inhale again, all the way up, feeling all that energy you just created with your breath. This time, turn the palms away from each other, and then start to reach it back as you fold forward, right? All the way down, the torso, maybe on top of your thighs, mostly on top of your thighs, and then the head is just going to hang. Maybe the hands are on your, on top of your feet, just releasing, and yes, it's a nose, your head. It's allowing the support of the back on your thighs, right? And then allowing the head to just create space for the pain over your thighs. And just breathing into this nice stretch in your neck. And then as you take another breath, you're going to keep your hands on your feet. And then start to straighten the spine forward and up halfway. Really reaching the crown of the head forward. So the spine is still nice and aligned. Keep breathing. Inhale, lengthen the spine forward. And then exhale, contract the belly up and into the spine. One last breath. Inhale, lengthen the spine forward. And then this time, exhale, forward fold again. Body down. And then as you take your next breath in, you're going to start to reach up, press down to the seat, reach your whole body up, arms wide and out and up. And exhale the hands back to your heart. We're going to do this one more time. Inhale, reach up, open up the heart, lengthen the spine. Exhale. Turn the palms away, lengthen as you fold forward. Place your hands on tops of the feet, release the head down. No weight, no tension. Inhale, halfway. lengthen the spine halfway forward and up. And then exhale, forward fold again, releasing back down through your thighs. Take your next inhale, circle the arms all the way up, engage your shape. Keep the core engaged, inhale all the way up, hands touching, exhale, hands to your heart. Close a half sun salutation. Okay? You still do lots of halves and stuff, depending on where we are in our practice. All right, let's get into our little bit of a core stretch. I always seem to go over, so I always have to watch my clock here. So from here, if you can, you can raise one leg up, grab your chair for support, keep the spine nice and tall. If you can, maybe both legs up. Right? If you can't, just do one leg at a time. Hold it for at least three breaths, and then switch sides. Hold that for three, right? Three breaths, hold it. Nice. If you can, challenge yourself, both legs up, right? Shoulders back and down. No tension, belly drawing into the spine as you exhale. Maybe one last one. And exhale. Now we do a little bit of movement, right? So now with your feet, we are going to move our feet just a tad, some warrior twos. So you want to straighten out that leg. You can rest on a block or on the floor, right? You want to start to point and flex our feet. So I don't know if you can see. I'm just going to show you. I'm just going to inhale here, exhale, flex, inhale, now flex, exhale. Now inhale here, flex, stay here, and start to move the feet side to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. And then maybe one more to the left, just kind of rotating and massaging the ankles here. And then maybe you'd like to start to turn the toes, turn the feet in and out, in and out, in and out. Now, maybe a couple more where you are. Just continue just like that. Just get a stretch of the ankle. Nice. And then place your feet, that foot down, and then start to lift the heels up, and then reach it down. Just really stretch your toes. Really stretch your feet. Think your calves are being activated here. And release that foot. Maybe you want to just shake it. Maybe you want to start to twist it around the ankle. Just release any tension you might have created. Just breathing in and out. Really nice. Let's do the opposite side. Release it back down. Press it coming down. Inhale, reach. Let's straighten out that right leg now and start to flex and point. Flex and point. Feel that you're stretching and really creating movement. Blood flow to your feet. You don't do this enough, so, you know, it's kind of hard sometimes to flex and point. Your body's just not used to it. A few more times, like, and then start to go sideways. Flex it and just go sideways. Back, right, and left, right, and left. Just feeling movement. Just want to bring some circulation to that foot. Breathing it. And then start to go in and out with the sides of our foot. And one last time. And slowly place the soles of the feet down. And then start to inhale, lift the heels up and down. Up and down. I can't really see it with my boot, but I am lifting up. Heels up and down, up and down. And again, rotating through the ankles, just releasing any tension in my back. And then from here, we're going to come into a warrior two position. Seat. So our legs can be as wide as you'd like. Toes are pointing away from each other. don't make it too wide if you have any like groin issues or something that's hurting. Now, if you can, if you'd like, you can always straighten out the left leg. That's something you can do. If you can't, just stay where you are. You're in the first position first. If you like to straighten out the left leg, you can. Okay? Up to you. If it's hurting you in any way, come back to the first position. But if you can, just like this, then we'll just start to inhale the arms up, reaching fingertips in opposite directions. Warrior two in a seated position, right? Maybe staring straight ahead, or if you have no neck issues, start to gaze to the right side of the room, towards the right fingertips. Just staying here, really pressing down through your seat, really pressing down through the soles of your feet, and really lifting the shoulders up, not the shoulders, the chest up, the shoulders down. Not trying to, a lot of times we hold it, start to get really uncomfortable, and then we start to hike up our shoulders. This is enough for you. Take one last breath and you can lower the arms down. If you can, challenge yourself. Turn that front, right palm up. And as you take a deep breath in, you're going to start to move that arm all the way up to the sky and over to the right ear. Then the left hand starts to slowly come back down, moving onto that left thigh or grabbing the chair. Inhale, reversing the warrior. And just breathing here, lifting up. No crunching. Lift up that spine. Open up the heart. As you take your next exhale, start to come all the way back. Warrior two, the arms come back, sending straight up a bit of each other. Really nice. Inhale here, one breath. Find nice length. As you exhale, bend that elbow, place the forearm, the right elbow forearm, all the way on the thigh, and then reach the left hand up. Side angle. Really nice. Just stay here for one breath here, and we're going to move the arm. Breathe in and out. Feel the stretch of your left hip. Maybe stretching up the groin. And take a deep breath in, reaching those left fingertips up. Exhale, start to lower the left arm to the ear. Keep lifting, pressing through the forearm, so lift the weight so you're not dumping all the weight of the body onto that right hand. Right thigh. Inhale all the way back up. Use your breath. And then exhale, reach the hip all the way back. Let's do that one more time. Inhale, reach up, open up. And then exhale, slowly. Inhale one last time, back up. Stay here. Exhale it all out through the lower belly and the spine. And then slowly reversing the warrior, we'll start to reach the left hand down, right hand up and over to the right ear. Reversing the warrior, beautiful. And then exhale, warrior two again. Very nice. Gotta do the other side. So from here, we're just gonna place our hands on our hips, bend that left knee, come bring it back again. You can always just stay here, but again, we're going to challenge ourselves. Maybe straighten out that right leg, right? Depending on how you can do it. You can feel opening up the hips. You don't have to have it as wide, right? You can have the legs closer together if you can straighten that leg out, right? You can always walk that foot even further out, depending on how stretched out your groin is. So as you're ready, take a deep breath in, reach and lengthen the arms in opposite direction. Remember that the shoulders are relaxed, the heart is lifted. The gaze starts to come all the way to that left side. You're just breathing in and out here. I think that rhythm you created in your practice as your own. Breathing in and breathing out. One last breath here. Find that sense of readiness, calm, warrior two. Turn that front palm up as you take that deep breath in. Start to inhale, reach that left hand up and over to the left ear. Right arm slides down to the thigh, opening up the heart. One last breath, inhale, lift the heart up. Beautiful, and exhale, come back to warrior two. Really nice. Take another deep breath here. As you exhale, bend that left elbow, start to place that forearm on the left thigh, reach the right hand up, side. Really nice. Breathe in and out. keep pressing down through that left forearm and lift the torso. Find lightness as you breathe in and out. As you take your next exhale, start to reach that right arm all the way down to the right ear. Inhale, reach that arm all the way back up. Exhale, reach the arm all the way down to the right ear. And then inhale, all the last one. Exhale, reach it all the way back. Forward, and inhale, all the way back. And then exhale, come all the way to your two. Really nice, push your hands on your hips. And walk your feet back to where they were. Like a tabletop position, right? Make sure it's nice and comfortable. We're going to open up our hips now a little bit. We're going to start to stretch out those hips. You know, stretch the hips enough so that you're sitting. You can place that right leg on top, right? A lot of the times, your knees will be nice and high. You've got nice tight hips, but it could just be that your hips are not supposed to be that way, right? It's not supposed to happen when you come down. So be very careful. Don't hurt yourself trying to push that knee down. Stay with your knees high. If you can already feel it in your hips, right? You don't want to overextend yourself and pull any ligaments in your hips. You don't want to do that. And you're just going to stay right here. If you feel it enough, we'll stay just like this and you're just going to breathe. If you want to feel a little bit more of a stretch, you can make sure that the spine is nice and tall. All we're doing is hinging at the hips. We're just gonna forward fold, right? Whole spine forwarding, down, fold, without rounding the back, right? You want the spine to be nice and aligned. You might feel that stretch a little bit more on that right hip as you fold forward. And wherever you are, don't go too deep. Just be able to feel it. It's a good stretch, and you're just gonna breathe into the stretch. Be careful to not overextend, overstretch anything. And taking one last deep breath in and out before inhaling back up to center. So let's do the opposite side. So reach that leg back down. Inhale, reach the left leg up. Left ankle on top of the right knee, right thigh. Just stay just like this. If you feel it, you can feel it in that left hip. This is enough. Stay here. If you want to fold and get a tiny bit more of a stretch, you can, right? You don't have to fold all the way. It's all about just your comfort level. And your knees can be as high as you would like, right? You just want to slowly fold forward as you exhale. The belly, when you draw the belly into the spine, you're creating space for the fold, right? Inhale, lengthen. And then exhale, fold. Stay where you feel comfortable. Just stay here and just focus on breathing. Breathing in and out equally as you did in the practice. Maybe closing your eyes. Just allowing yourself to feel the sensation without any visual. Just breathing in and out. That's good. Opening up your hips. This side, you need more of a stretch, right? More time to breathe. It's always one side that needs more. It's completely balanced. Physically. Just take care, mindful of your body, what the limitations are. When you're ready, inhale all the way back up. Nice, very nice. And then slowly reach that leg down. Oh, feels so good. Feels like all my muscles are relaxed now. All right. We're going to do one more bone arrow thing. It's bone arrow. It's kind of fun. You know, you're kind of like acting like you have this mat in your arrow. So we're going to reach both legs out wide again. Okay. And we're going to start to reach the arms all the way across. Okay. We're going to start to gaze to the right arm, and we're going to inhale, reach the left hand up in front and over, and then start to grab that imaginary pole, right? As you exhale, start to stretch, reach that left arm all the way back, pulling the bow, and then add, letting it release, watching it go to that target that it has. So reaching it all, reaching that left arm all the way back. Let's do it again. Inhale, reach that left arm up and over, grab that bow and arrow, start to reach and stretch it out. Exhale, release, and watch that arrow go to that goal path, right? Inhale, get last one. Inhale all the way up and over. Exhale, start to stretch out that bow and release the arrow to that point. Gaze all the way to the left side now. Inhale, reach the right hand all the way up and over to the left. Grab that bow and arrow. Exhale, reach and stretch out that right arm and release. See that arrow go to that target. Inhale, reach all the way back up. Right hand coming all the way forward towards the left side. Grab that imaginary arrow and exhale, release it. Last one. Inhale, reach that arm all the way up over to the left. Grab that bow. Exhale, stretch out that right arm straight, release. And the last one time, all the way back, push your feet back. Really nice. If you feel like you need to maybe come to the edge of the seat and maybe start to move your knees a little bit, release any tension you might have in your hips, right? Sometimes all that tension causes a little bit more tightness, so just to release it all, right? Feels really good. All right, where are we now? Oh, okay. So let's come back, come all the way back so that we're nice and tall on the chair. We're not at the edge of the chair anymore. We're almost done, I guess. Let me see the time. I don't realize how fast it goes. Almost time. So place your hands on your thighs. Allow the shoulders, if you need to move it a little bit, to release down. Find comfort in your seat again. And just close your eyes. Notice your whole body, all the movement, activity that you created in your body. It's bringing brand new energy, this prana, this life force within you. Come back to the breath. Start to let go of creating it. Just gently allow your body to breathe for you without thought, without effort. An effortless breath that just gently moves your body. Just feeling, being aware of the sensation of your body. To notice your face and just imagine that you are flexing or tensing your face. It's just been until one, really tight. And as you feel the exhale, you release all the muscles in your face, your forehead, your cheeks, your jaws, your ears, your whole face is completely relaxed. And awareness now of your shoulders, feeling that tightening and tensing of your shoulders, maybe even riding up. And as you exhale, just releasing all the muscles, feeling your shoulders reaching down softly without any effort. Just feeling the comfort of your head and your shoulders. Notice your chest and your belly. Take a breath in. Feel yourself activated, tensing your chest and your belly. As you exhale, completely release any tension in the belly. And the next breath, noticing your right hip and your right buttocks, really engaging and tensing it slightly before you exhale. maybe releasing it down. Sing down the left hip and the left buttock, or the right or the left, I'm not sure which one I think is. Just tensing that opposite hip and opposite bum, and then as you exhale, releasing all the muscles, letting your whole half of your body just relaxing. Just relaxing your bum, and your body just resting. A little bit of engagement, though. To keep you supported and calm, but completely relaxed. Breathing in. Start to take a breath in, really engaging your whole entire leg. Flexing the feet, spreading the toes, engaging and tensing. As you exhale, completely release that right leg all the way down. No muscle movement, completely. Again, inhale, noticing and activating the left entire leg from your hips all the way down to the toes, tensing and spreading the toes. With the exhale, gently releasing it all down the legs. Now, slowly relaxing, finding stillness in your whole entire body. Natural and smooth and effortless. Imagining as you stay here in stillness, the next natural tide of breath brings within you this beautiful white light. Starting from the crown of the head, it spreads through your body, creating balance, creating purification of your whole entire being, in the physical and the mental. Just taking another breath in, really feeling that white light spreading throughout your whole entire body. All the way to the tips of the fingers, and the tips of the toes, the body radiating out. Nourishing to the cleanses and placing your hands gently to your heart center and also move your hands to prayer. Reminding yourself that you are here for you to always care for yourself so you can take care of others. Find peace within your heart, in your soul, to let go of all things that do not serve you. Thank you. and finding always gratitude every day. In honor of all that we are and all that there is. Namaste.
How was that?
It was great. Very
good.
Nice.
Aw, I'm glad. Say that again.
We
kind of. Oh, I broke my foot about maybe 7 weeks ago. It's not healing. It doesn't want to heal.
Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, I usually teach two regular flow classes at night, Monday, Wednesday at Prema, and then I teach a breathing restore class Thursday mornings, but can't really do anything with this foot. So now I'm doing chair yoga, and I also do the yoga nidra on Friday afternoons.
Yeah, I've done that a couple times. With you. I will see you this Friday afternoon.
Yeah. How are you with the yoga nidra? Are you like really staying awake or?
I'm staying awake. I sometimes get into a state where I'll miss a few words.
Which is fine.
But yeah. I don't fall asleep. Connie and I love it. It's so nice.
Oh,
and
good.
It just feels so wonderful afterwards.
Yeah, so, well, you're like really resting your mind and your body, you know?
Exactly.
And yeah.
And we need that right now. I mean, everybody's so on edge.
I have been trying to promote it. Even I've been like giving out free classes, and you know, if people are just like, we're not moving, this is not moving, I want to move. So, but I'm like, this is going to rest you.
Exactly. I want to move too, but I also want to rest and be bored. And that's every bit as important as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah. Well, thanks for taking my class, and I'll see you Friday. Thank you.
See you then. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.